Good morning, everyone. I'd like to welcome you aboard the bright morning star. We're underway now for our nature cruise to the Coronado Islands. My name is Ben. I'll be the captain. We have two other captains working on deck today, Steve and Junior. A few things required by the Coast Guard that you know. All life jackets are located under the seats in the galley. They're a vest-type jacket. They go over your shoulders like any other vest, and they have two straps that tie in the front. Life rafts are located on the upper deck, and on the aft end of the vessel, in case of an emergency, would be dispatched over the side by the crew. Now, we've never had need of any of that equipment. We don't ever expect to, but however, you do need to know where it's located. We'll get up to speed here, and we'll start to tell you a little bit about the harbor. Now, our Maritime Museum here in San Diego. Quite an interesting place to visit if you're interested in naval history or naval aviation. On the other side of the vessel, on the right, when we went out, is the Carnival Elation. Does 4 and 5 day trips to Cabo San Lucas. It's here all the time, based in San Diego. Number 76 is the Ronald Reagan. We also have number 72, the Abraham Lincoln. I know there's a number you folks don't know what you got into today, but I honestly believe this is the best excursion. Kind of oval shape, half an oval. That's the old Dumbo hangars, the big seaplanes they used to call Dumbos. They had huge wings on top of the fuselage.
What that does is run roughly north and south. It's about 6 miles long. The next thing you get to northwest is that the largest part of the world.
You want to be in line by, say, 7 o'clock, and you want to have to be underway by midnight. Fishing really is quite good here in the harbor. The recreational fishing pier for San Diego Municipal Pier is on the other side of the harbor. You can see a white rail going around it. It's quite nice. Now, as you look at Point Loma to the right, you can see where private property ends and government property starts. Those old homes up there, many of the homes were built back the turn of the 20th century, and of course they've been refurbished and so forth. Most of those are still owned by the original Portuguese and Italian immigrant families. They were concreted over, and they had a railway that and delivered coal. But he had diesel engines and so forth right after the First World War. Things started being changed over, but the Navy figured, look, we've already got these big bunkers. They're already dug out, so why not dig them out a little bit more and put the fuel tanks in? And that's what they did. To this day, those fuel tanks are in the ground. But destroyers and ships of lesser size still put the fuel there. The pier on the left is a condition. Munitions. Those munitions are stored in bunkers. And you'll be able to see them. You can see a few of them back there. There are mounds of dirt over the top of steel and concrete bunkers. It's a very secure area. Foreign or domestic, naval, military, any kind of major ship is escorted out of the harbor.
Comes all the way back to the right where you can see that white fence goes around, more of the cemetery. All of those plots up there are either filled or spoken for. The only way a vet can get into that national cemetery now is his ashes put into a vault. Sign up for the
Torpedoes and sea-to-air missiles, and they carry 16 intercontinental ballistic missiles, each with two warheads. They actually fill those compartments full of water, and it sinks right there at the dock. He fully intended to come back and sail up into the bay and explore the bay. He was totally intrigued with it. You can tell by the notes that he made. He had quite an attraction to this bay. Muskets for shooting deer and that type of thing, in exchange for sea otter shells. Now at that time, the San Diego Bay was loaded with sea otters. And they brought top dollar when they got back to the phenomenon where the stones come in with a tide, they end up on Ballast Point. Well, they thought they'd use the ballast, and when they got back, they just dumped the stone. And they, from that time on, they kept carrying the stones until they had no more market for them. During January and February during the migration. Why in the world they built a lighthouse up there is beyond anyone, because it's so high out of the water that when you see the lighthouse, you couldn't see it. You can see it though too. They built it down at a specific location, the base of Point Walls. To the right of the lighthouse, you can look into the water with just a cheap pair of Polaroid glasses, like looking from a glass bottom boat. You'll see little lobsters and crabs and sea urchins and sea anemones and you name it. Now you can pick them up and look at them. They had generators that charged batteries, and then everything ran off the direct current of the batteries. Average in size as whales go. They're about full-grown adult that's 40 to 45 feet long, and they weigh about a ton to the foot. Blue whale, and a full-grown blue adult whale will be in the neighborhood of 100 feet long and weigh about 100 tons. Now, to give you some perspective on it, this boat is 105 feet long. Toothed whales, like killer whales, have a single nostril that supports both lungs. So when they exhale, it doesn't go nearly as wide as a gray whale, but it'll go much higher. dolphin here will slide over. We're gonna work across the South Coronado Island and look for the dolphin. And Jose Vizcaino, a Spanish sailor in 1620, came by, and he was very impressed. He was the one that named them the Coronados.
These are white sides. Sometimes they'll come right up on the bow, though. If you look straight down, sometimes they'll be right under the bow. Thank you.
daisies and so forth up in little clumps where that seed is blown from offshore. They're pretty pudgy. They're pretty well fed. We'll get in here where everybody gets a good look. One newborn pup, see him this morning. You see how they move? They're not at all good on land. this cove here is the one man by himself. We got one in the water. Got a chance there to see how well those felines maneuver on the beach. They literally run. Thank you.
Groupies are a phenomenal bird. If you watch them in the air, they can turn on a dime. Terrific at flight. We saw one for the first time about a week ago. Thank you.